Living organisms must carry out a diverse set of tasks, such as building and maintaining physical structures, importing and exporting substances, and passing genetic information on to progeny. At their most basic level, these tasks involve chemical reactions. As we study in detail how organisms perform the tasks required for life, it is important to understand some basic concepts relating to chemical reactions in cells. This module focuses on these essential concepts. We can start with the concept of Gibbs free energy, or G. A rigorous development or definition of Gibbs free energy is not necessary to understand the concepts we teach in this course. So you can think of the Gibbs free energy as the amount of energy available to do work in a chemical system. By a chemical system, I simply mean a collection of molecules existing at a particular place under particular environmental conditions. In this course, we can think of a chemical system as consisting of particular types of molecules dissolved at some concentration in an aqueous solution. For a chemical system, that is, a chemical compound dissolved in water, the value of G depends on two major factors. First, the chemical nature of the compound, and second, the environmental conditions. The nature of the molecule can't be changed. It's defined by its chemical structure, and it is what it is. But the environmental conditions, namely the temperature, pressure, and concentrations of the molecules, can vary. Normally in biochemical reactions, the most important of these environmental conditions to consider is concentration. The more concentrated a molecule is in solution, the greater is Gibbs free energy. So, of the solutions represented here, the one on the left has the lowest Gibbs free energy, and the one on the right has the highest. Now, consider a general chemical reaction, which has reactants and products. The reaction can proceed in the forward direction, in which the reactants are transformed into products, or in the reverse direction, where the so-called products are converted into the reactants. Which direction is favored is dictated by the change in the Gibbs free energy, or the delta G, that happens during the reaction. Delta G is the difference in Gibbs free energy between the reactants and the products, and is defined as G of their products minus G of the reactants. To illustrate this concept, we commonly use reaction coordinate diagrams. The Gibbs free energies of the reactants and products of a chemical reaction are plotted on the y-axis, and the x-axis represents the progress of the reaction. To go from reactants to products or vice versa, the molecules must pass through high energy intermediates, which are represented as a bump or a hill on the diagram. Keep in mind that the delta G for a chemical reaction will change depending on the prevailing conditions. Sometimes it's helpful to be able to make comparisons between different chemical reactions without having to worry about the contribution of the environmental conditions to the Gibbs free energy. I want to explain some conventions scientists use to make free energy comparisons easier, so you'll understand the difference between delta G and standard delta G. Chemists have defined a set of standard environmental conditions that can be applied, in theory, to any reaction. The chemical standard state is defined as a temperature of 298 Kelvin, or 25 degrees Celsius, a pressure of 1 bar, which is almost the same as 1 atmosphere, and a concentration of 1 mole per liter, or 1 molar, for each reactant or product. The change in Gibbs free energy for a reaction occurring under these conditions is called the standard Gibbs free energy change, or standard delta G. We represent the standard delta G by putting a little circle or degrees sign after the G. Many biochemical reactions involve protons and water molecules. Because the concentration of pure water is about 55 moles per liter, and most biochemical reactions occur near neutral pH, it doesn't make much sense for the standard state of biochemical reactions to consider the water and proton concentrations to be 1 molar. So biochemists have come up with a biochemical standard state in which we define the proton concentration to be 10 to the minus 7 moles per liter, equal to a pH of 7, and we assume the concentration of water is constant at 55.5 moles per liter. All other reactants are defined to be at a concentration of 1 molar. We designate the delta G in the biochemical standard state by adding a prime after the degree sign. Because the standard conditions are defined, the values of the chemical standard delta G and the biochemical standard delta G depend only on the nature of the molecules in the reaction. Therefore, these values are constant for a particular reaction and will be the same as each other if the reaction doesn't involve water or protons. The plain or non-standard delta G depends not only on the nature of the reaction itself, but also on the conditions that are present at any given moment, and therefore changes as environmental conditions change. In this video, we have seen how delta G is defined. In the next video, we'll look at how delta G changes as a reaction proceeds.